guys, namaste, namaskaram, how are you all? I hope you all are doing great. And as always, I am back with another informative video, and this time it's all about Emirates cabin crew salary. If you are willing to join Emirates, I am sure you must be wondering how much money you will be making. Continue watching this video until end. You will have a lot of clarity after watching this video. And if you are not cabin crew, not willing to become a crew, still here, that means you are keen and interested about knowing cabin crew lifestyle, how much they earn for traveling the world, and also how much in a Dubai dirham they are making, because they have a lavish lifestyle for sure. They are living in Dubai, they are getting free accommodation, and on top of that they are earning tax free salary. So how much exactly Emirates cabin crew earn? Another disclaimer which I would like to give here is this is entry level salary. That means once you are joining Emirates cabin crew, at the first step how much you will be making economy crew at the base level. So now, the longer you stay in the company, the more promotion you will be getting. Of course, you will be promoted to business class crew, your basic will increase, your flying hours will increase. Also, later you'll be promoted as a supervisor, everything is gonna be increased dramatically all over again. So in this video, I'm giving you only hint about entry level salary, nothing else. To understand in total how much they are earning, you must understand how we are paid as a cabin crew. In every airline, be it Emirates, Qatar, Etihad, Air India, or any domestic airline, we all are always paid like in a three different way. First is your basic salary, second is your flying hours, and the third is your hotel meal allowance. As you all know that we are living in a different countries, we are traveling, so you are staying in hotel and you will be eating your food. So company is paying you hotel meal allowance also. In this three part, your salary will be divided and in total, you are getting towards the end. So let's understand what is basic pay. Basic pay is even if you are on a leave, you are not flying for that month, you are on your annual leave or maybe your sick leave, which is paid, you will be getting this amount for sure. That doesn't vary if you are not flying. How much is the basic salary now? Let's get it very clearly. It's 4,260 dirham. That is the basic salary of Emirates cabin crew at entry level. Now, what is flying hours? So for example, if you are a cabin crew, of course you will be getting roster every month and you fly certain hours. So just let me give my example. If I got my roster and I see total flying hours, I have 90 hours this month, or maybe you can say approximately it comes in between 80 to 100 depending upon which month it is. If it is of hours where people are flying more and people are on leave, you get extra hours more than 100 also. But for this video, we'll stick to 80 hours. So for example, if I have 80 hours to fly this month, per hour, how much I am going to make? Per hour, it is 61.25 dirham. Approximately, you will be making per hour that much. Now, you can divide, you can multiply that into 80 and you will get the approximate idea how much flying hours you'll be making this month. Now, as we are clear with the basic, we are clear with the flying hours. Third part is we are traveling. So now we are going to New York. Company will give me flying allowance, sorry, meal allowance. Now meal allowance, as much as I know, in Qatar Airways we used to get with our salary. So basically wherever you are traveling, you have to spend from your own account. Whatever you want to spend, it's your own account and you will be using your own money. However, here in Emirates at hotel, they are giving them in a local currency. So if you are going to New York, you will be getting local currency in US dollar. If you are going to Europe, you will be getting paid in European currency. Now remember, this is only meal allowance. So company will pay you according to the city expenses and how expensive the country is. So basically, if you are going to Delhi, your allowance will be paid in Indian currency and as per the Delhi expense. Now if you are going to, it doesn't mean that if you are going to India, you will be paid same amount all the time. No, Delhi can be paid little higher than maybe Chennai. So similarly, even if you are going to US, it can differ. Maybe in New York you are getting paid $150, and in some other city you might be getting less than that, even if it is in US. So I hope you got it. Let's take example here, $100 for example per layover. Now you are reaching to hotel and you are getting paid in local currency there. They are paying you only for meal allowance. If you want to do shopping and all, that is your own expense, you will have to spend. But this is paid by company to eat your food, three, depending upon how many days you are going to stay. So if you're going to stay 2 days, they will pay you for breakfast, lunch, dinner, breakfast, lunch, dinner. So basically two breakfast, two lunch and two dinner. But if you are going to stay for 1 day, they'll pay you for 1 day allowance only. Now in that way you can calculate your salary. Mainly approximately any F2 in Dubai will be F2, I am calling it because I'm used to calling F2 to economy cabin crew. I don't know what they call it, but as a new joiner, when you recently started flying, approximately for 90 to 95 hours you will be total making almost 11,000 or 10,000 to 11,000 local dirham. Now remember the perks also, do not forget to count that. You don't have to pay for electricity, you don't have to pay for your accommodation, it's all free. And apart from that, you get a lot of discount in all the restaurants, most of the salons, everywhere. Emirates cabin crew are getting 20% 30% discounts all the time. So that is also another benefit which you are getting apart from your salary. And the most important thing, tax free. So you don't have to worry about tax. Whatever came to your account, it's completely yours. Now you can convert it in your local currency. For example, me as an Indian, if I want to save something, I can convert that money in Indian account and I can keep something for my expenditure, remaining I can save it, or depending upon which kind of person you are, what is your priority. Maybe if you are not planning to save much and you are planning to spend more, travel more, so do that. All the best guys. I hope this video was clear.